Live, we are more than just talk.
The gunner for my alchemist gold. Offer me a price I couldn't resist, I never sold. It's funny how they fronted when I told them I was cold, and they all grabbed their gooses when the first dummy froze. See, I'm from out the darkest side of spaces, the light years of travel type of places. Psyrock from out the friend's division, broadcasting through your brainwaves, so turn off your television. Listen, I don't have the time or the energy, battle rapping clowns just so I can get an enemy. This is not my body, just a loner that was given me. I am not a human, but a certified entity. My sound waves travel clear across the nations. Suckers in a frenzy, but I be your meditation. I run with the lower, I guess you could call me Haitian. Birth name Asada, I'm sorry, there's no relation. Patience, young Padawan, learn the basics. MC DJ B-Roll graffiti, the four faces. Face it, we don't do no faking round here. We dispensing jewelry for the taking round here.
I bounce from planet to planet and now I'm here. I built the pyramids, now the devil's in fear. The power's in our numbers and I'm here to show you how. That when we come together, know it's nation time now. I bounce from planet to planet and now I'm here. I built the pyramids, now the devil's in fear. The power's in our numbers and I'm here to show you how. That when we come together, know it's nation time now.
I'm stirring up the sugar in my honey pot, writing down the methods for the magic that I conjure up. Black as Abyssinian, see me and call me Kunjo. Bussing different languages, okay, call me Mutombo. That's for another situation. I spit in English dialect cause of colonization. You don't wanna hear it, that's cool, take a vacation. Grow up younger Link cause your lyricism is nascent.
Mix it.
Light skin, locked up, no I'm not a Rasta. You can catch my dirty wine at a pasa. Pretty young thing, Michael Jackson. Many times I cover so I won't be a distraction. Follow me down through the rabbit hole. Try and figure how deep the knowledge of the planet go. Lights out, darkness, no place for the frightened. Down here we even make the dim wits enlighten. I ain't doing this for the pomp or the circumstance. I'm just trying to prove that intelligence is relevant. Put that on your pipe then you smoke it, and later you can tell them I'm the dopest.
I bounce from planet to planet and now I'm here. I built the pyramids, now the devil's in fear. The power's in our numbers and I'm here to show you how. That when we come together, know it's nation time now. I bounce from planet to planet and now I'm here. I built the pyramids, now the devil's in fear. The power's in our numbers and I'm here to show you how. That when we come together, know it's nation time now.
Listen, that was the guy hop. Psyrock, she said it's nation time. This is what we do in the show, y'all. Welcome back to the Sabir Bey Show on LA Talk Live. Again, it's like I always repeat myself. It's like the hottest show around right now. I'm keeping it 100. And shout out to my man Joe that's actually engineering, sending out tweets and all the stuff on lines. Jessica's doing the same thing, and I would like you to do the same thing. That track that went off was by my sister Psyrock from the God Hop movement up in Atlanta. You know, shout out to her and her husband, man. But that piece was hot. She said it's nation time. So go check her out. It's SA-ROC. I'm going to repeat that again. SA-ROC. And you will hear her dropping some jewels on the Moors. So listen, call some of these radio stations and tell them to play Sister Psyrock. But she never sold out. But she always have a message. She said, if we unify, it ain't, you know, they can't do nothing. So listen, it's called nation time. And listen, I want to do this because this is going to be a tense, good show for everybody. So I'm going to take a little time so y'all can tweet it out to everybody. Tell these so-called scholars to listen to the show, to rebut what I'm saying. Listen, before they do that, make sure you tweet out or put on Facebook, wherever. Cross your T's and dot your I's, okay? This is what we're doing here. This is how we do on the Sabir Bey Show. This is the 2D edition. We do also have a Friday edition with the hip-hop lessons every Friday with my man Anthony. But my co-host will not be sitting with me, Alberto and Sal. And they take care of some personal issues. But I do have my brother, Rick, in the building. You'll see him coming in real soon. So, again, Take some time. Tell a friend. Call us up, 323-473-3100. Again, 323-473-3100. You can give me a call. Do not wait until the last minute. We only have an hour and a half on this show, but our Friday shows is actually 3 hours. So please, tell a friend. Sabir Bey Show is on. Give us a call. Do not wait till the last minute. Go tell your so-called scholars the show is on right now, you know, because there's a lot of stuff they're not telling our people. So we're going to come back with some news before we get into our subject matter. Are our so-called black scholars telling the truth about our history over here in the Americas? I didn't say the United States. I said in the Americas, which means north, south, and central. That means Canada, Brazil, Venezuela, Haiti, Trinidad, Barbados. Do I need to go on? Okay, so listen. Tell a friend. Sabir Bey Show is on. Listen, we're going to go back to some music. I just want to give y'all some time to pull up your internets, open up another window, tell a friend, get online, chat about it. The show is on. It's going live. Do not hit it later. But this is my sister, Sirach. Always pay attention to the lyrics that this sister or any other artist I play on this show, on the Sabir Bey Show, all right? We'll be right back. Listen close. Listen close. Can't change a person's mind. You can only shift them.
Why don't you let me turn you on like ignition? Spark, catch a fire, then brain reflect prisms. Noble activity, pulse down the axon. Teach your regimen like wax off, wax on. You wanna see, take the rose, cut it lens off. Third eye activated, oral shield cleanse off. Tighten up the cipher, give your friend a means to send off. I came, saw, I conquered the struggle, and then I've been gone. Out of space, in a self, in the ether. Spooked by the door, turning gangs into sleeper. Cells overthrew regime with a mind blink. Can you think how deep the wicked government can sink? But you rather deal with plastic than real. Mute your nerve ending so your body can't feel. Revel in debauchery, celebrate the bill. Offer up your jugular vein for satisfying meals. Mills, mills. It's getting late in the street lights are all lit. Better play your cards for the game, make you forfeit. Death dealers circling, waiting for fresh caucus. Discipline fast for 30 days, black caucus. Pause it, cause it, wait for the effect though. Break your mama's back, gonna crack, watch your steps. So what you putting out there don't follow you through your doorway. Murder king marker, they say you should have it your way. Individualism killing the people's nation. Building, jump up and you hit the glass ceiling. Hoping that the scratch ticket said you won a million. Tricks off a kid, silly rabbit hit the children. Bang on the system, gang on the system. Circle back and bless another around when you miss them. Seven generations will suffer from your decisions. You can't change a mind, young one, so shift them, shift them, shift them, shift them. Get down if you down, if not then ease back. These industry cats bite like rabbits wolf packs. Keep some silver bullets in my denim knapsack. With my stardust and trail mixing universal map pack light. Cause I never know when I leap the ground. Keep my weight up going pound per pound now. Sound for sound rounds like the circle of drums. You can stick it out in bravery or haul off and run. Pray to God that he resurrect the prodigal son. Bet you scoff if I let you know that you was the one. Cause a man don't believe that he's more than a man. But a God know the truth that I am what I am. Overstand what I'm saying, then play it again. And let him marinate like some leaking parents. Take a jump off the cliff but prepare all your friends. Cause it's deep where we going, so beware of the bends.
Woo! Welcome back, everybody, to the Sabir Bey Show. That was my sister and your sister, Sirach. So, yo, go check her out. If y'all think hip, again, I keep telling y'all, but that's the Friday show. If y'all think hip-hop is dead, it's not. And now we'll put my money any given day up on my sister, Sirach. She said, you can't change their minds. You can only shift them. And this is what we do at this show on Tuesdays. And actually, Fridays, too. And, again, I always want to give a shout-out to my whole crew, man, because it's not just about me, and I'm not into anyone like following me I don't look for that. And this is the problem that we're having right now with a lot of these so-called black leaders. We're looking for people to follow us. You know what I mean? Just keep doing what you're doing. I don't like labels. I don't like titles. My title, Bey, is enough. You know what I mean? Bey is enough. It just means governor. So I do govern myself, and I govern things that surround me. So this is just how it is. But listen, the show is going to be good. Wait for my man Rick to get back in the room. I don't know where he just went at, but he... You know, I said I'm going to open up the platform for him so he can actually get something up basically off his chest. You know what I mean? He wanted to talk about pertaining to these black scholars, because I hear a lot of stuff also, but I really don't feed into it, and they would never allow me at any of their events because I'm not the emotional one. Like Lauryn Hill, I let the emotions get crucified. I don't rock with it. I deal with factology. So again, they don't allow me to come there because I'm not talking about how we were just slaves and how, you know, white supremacy. I would say, well, if you have a white supremacy, create a black supremacy. That's how you handle that issue. I'm going to repeat that again for all y'all that out there that says this, white supremacy. And to tell you, too, they do think the Nation of Islam is like a black supremacy. But anyway, instead of keep saying it, why don't you just put the clean glass up against the dirty glass? You know what I mean? I don't rock with that because I know better than that, and I know my history. So I don't rock with the white supremacy. I don't rock with what they say, post-traumatic slave syndrome, whatever that is. I don't know what it is. But anyway, also, because if that's the case, my sons should have post-traumatic being shot syndrome many times if I've been shot before they were here, and I think one of them was here when I got shot. So I don't rock with none of those things. And if I'm wrong, I'm always here for correction. You know, and they can feel free to call me at 323-473-3100. But before we get into this, I got some news and some stuff I want to build on. Like I said, I'm away from a man to call it. I mean, come in. But I'm also will welcome your calls on the line. Again, this is what we do on the Tuesday show. It's called Pure Edutainment. All right. Now, I just took a trip. And shout out to my man Byron, man. Byron up there in San Diego. I just was in San Diego this past weekend, and it was so funny because I run through Mexico. I don't know if you ever been there before, but I drove through Mexico with my assistant Karen, and it was just hilarious when we were there coming back. And people say you need a passport to cross the border, so you don't need it going over there anyway, to tell you the truth. But when we were coming back, because of my name, I had, you know, they was asking me like a million and one questions, but I showed them a regular state ID of Philadelphia. So they asked me where I was from, and I said Philadelphia, but I live in LA. And they asked my Karen where she was from, and she said, well, I'm from Oklahoma, but I live in LA. So we both showing state ID. So as we're sitting in a car, I said, I know they getting ready to go in on me just because of my name, you know. And I'm leading up to this to tell you something about this passport issue. But when I was there, you know, he asked me for my ID. I gave it to him. So he leans over and asks for my information on my IDs and blah, zee, blah, and think that I didn't know, you know, what it was. So whatever he was playing with at the border booth, he was looking things up. So anyway, as he's looking these things up, he says to me, what is your social security number? So whatever he was looking up, he had my information already in the computer. So he said, Bey, could you give me your social security number again? Like I was going to give him something different, or it wasn't me. And to say this, I'm saying this to say that we have to understand that the border should be illegal anyway, not the people. You follow me? But I'm just saying that when you look at these, how they come over here and they do the stuff that they're doing. But I do stuff purposely before I go out, because you have a lot of people who go out here who, number one, don't do research on anything. Even like I said, your scholars, they stop growing or getting, you know, knowledge at a certain point. So what happens, I'm a researcher. I research the researcher, and I want you to research me. That's how I tell people. Do not take anything what Sabir says here at face value. You're not paying me $15,000 or $5,000 for just paperwork. I'm doing these things on my own. So when I was going through the border, they asked me for this information. Now, mind you, when it came up, my ID says Sabir Bey. Okay, cool. They asked me, where's my passport at? And we got into a whole thing about the passport issue. And he said, you should get one. And I really wanted to go there, but I didn't want to, because I'm looking like, y'all want to roll, you know, get into San Diego. And I actually hit everybody up that I was in San Diego. But to show you that you don't need it. So as right now, I'm going through an issue dealing with this passport. And I know they probably listening to this, because I told the guy yesterday he can Google my name and find out who I am, because there was two different names on birth and now. And I say, well, all my documents says Sabir Bey. If you can Google me, if the person at the border can hit my social or their social, because it's not mine, I didn't create it, their social, Sabir will pop up. So as I'm on the phone with the passport lady, she said before 1930s, you didn't need a passport. I don't think y'all heard me when I said that. Before 1930s, you didn't need a passport. Let me show you something about history and Noble Drolley, how brilliant this man was. Any more knows this. And I believe I have it on me. If my man was in, I actually would try to get in my pocket right now to actually get it. I have a nationality card that an elder gave me back in Philadelphia, probably in 1999, with Noble Drolley's signature on the back of it. Okay? If anyone who studies Moorish history knows that Noble Drolley gave our nationality cards in 1913s to 1920s, our nationality cards were passports. That's what it was called, your passport. To understand of really what I'm saying to you, that passports now is from coming from one corporate state to another corporate state, not from one country to another country. And I'm leading to this for a reason. Every state, Congress, not Sabir's words, not none of my crew words, United States, every state in this union or in the United States were referred to as countries before the 1700s. I'm going to repeat this again. Every state were countries. So to come from one country, that's like California, Pennsylvania, New Jersey. They were all countries at one time. So to travel from one country to the next country did not need a passport. But your nationality card was basically that. It wasn't the corporate thing that you see today. So I'm building with the lady on the phone, and I'm like, thank you. You sharing a lot of stuff with me, you know, about this passport situation. I was like, wow, okay. That's what's up. You know, I said, you don't know how much you just gave me. But I already knew that. But most people don't know that's what goes down, okay? So I just wanted to put that out there, everybody. So, yes, I was in Mexico. And then when I was in Mexico, the people that, I mean, to see the Mexican brothers, they were so dark in Tijuana. It blew my mind. I said, wow, you don't show these people on TV. But I did want to stay there long enough to build with them about the Moriscos. And I know they're familiar with it. And for those that don't know, Morisco means Moor, which means little Moor or the Spanish Moors. And I'm going into this for a reason. All right. So that's one to put that out there. Also, I just found out that Obama was in Cuba. Obama was in Cuba building on human rights. Now, follow me, people. I'm doing this for a reason. And when I say scholars, I'm talking about all of them. He's a constitutional attorney, whatever you want to call him. All right. He's in another country talking about human rights violations. Okay. Never speak about human rights up here, nor about the police officers killing brothers. Okay. I'm going to repeat that again. He's in Cuba. When you see them speak in other countries, they dealing with nationalities. They dealing with human rights violation. When you see these Negro black leaders, or whatever you want to call these Negroes out here today, that is screaming for civil rights, and civil rights doesn't even apply in law. Okay, I'm going to say this again. It does not apply in law. Listen, he's down there building. Mugabe spoke about human rights. Many other nations build about human rights violations, but Obama, the president of the United States, of the United States, is building on human rights in another country and not speaking about the human rights violations that they're doing on these brothers, killing these brothers out here today. You took a long time, brother. I mean, you're killing me, bro. I'm just throwing out, I want to know your thoughts on it. But this is what happens, because when you're dealing with a people that do not have a nationality, they're basically property. And this is why I keep saying these so-called black scholars. Again, if I'm wrong on anything, please correct me. Black lives don't matter. Let's be realistic with it. And that's why I said I'm not here to change your mind. I'm here to shift it. I'm here to show you, to put this up against what they're putting out there and see how long. There was a brother, I can't think of the name. Oh, man, I had to pull out my phone. The brother just actually had to go on my phone. and look on my phone and see exactly. I got to find this quote. This brother just said it on Facebook. He said that the reason why they're killing us like we're crazy is because we're waking up. This is what he said. He said, because we're waking up to what is happening, you know, they're killing us. And Noble Drolley said these things back then. So again, why am I saying all these things? Because my man, and he keep walking out the room. Could you go get him, man? Tell him to come on, man. Because he keep jumping up out the chair. I'm saying these things because a lot of people are keep running behind these same behind black leaders that is misleading our people. And I know the truth don't sell. I'm being 100. The truth don't sell. People don't want to hear the truth. They want to live in a fantasy world. This is just how it is. But let me throw out some things. And I do want to show one of these books from the late great Dr. Ben. When people speak about the Moors, Dr. Ben speaks about the Moors in this book about the culture. Where we at? The Africans of North Africa, Northwest Akiba line, Africa, called Moors, preserved much of their ancestors, teaching the works and teaching the works of our people. And this is in Dr. Ben's book. For those people that keep doubting the Moors as some type of religious group and all these other things, no, he's talking about the Moors. And he makes the connection between the Africans. You have to remember, Dr. Ben was an Ethiopian. Okay? I'm going to pull out another book. There's another great book. I'm trying to get this brother here. I want y'all to see this book real quick. This book here. It talks about how the first Americans were Africans. With documents. Right? Speaking about how we were here, or the Hopi people that was here. H-O-P-I. Go look it up. Again, do not take Sabir's word for it. The Hopi people. Okay? So, again, I'm just throwing these books out here so everybody can look it up. And actually, when you start studying, and actually, there's another good book that's right here, too. When Rocks Cry Out by my man Horace Butler. I want y'all to go out there and get these books, because most of your scholars are not talking about these books that I'm bringing up right now. They're not bringing up any of this information. So, again, I want you to look these things up. And I'm going to read something off taken from J.E. Rogers' book. J.E. Rogers talks about the Ethiopians and Moors were properly used to describe the so-called blacks until the 1500s. I'm going to repeat this again. Ethiopian and Moors were properly used to describe the so-called blacks until the 1500s. So, let's go back into history. And again, if y'all don't believe me, then again, do not believe me. This is what I want you. Don't believe me. Don't believe me. Look it up. I'm giving you this. And none of your scholars are giving you this information. So again, please give me a call, 323-473-3100. And let's clear this up. When we speak on dealing with a slave trade, and I'm not one to say slavery did not exist. Slavery did, and it's still going on today. When I hear people say the Moors say that slavery did not exist, we're not saying it did never exist. It's happening today. But when you look at the time frame of slavery, or number one, let's clarify, let's dissect that word slave. Slave, number one, come from the word Slavic. It's your Russians captured by the Germans. I'm going to repeat this again. Do not take my word for it. When you start studying this information, you will see it. Slave come from the word Slavic. S-L-A-V-I-C. Look it up in any Webster's dictionary. A lot of you Pan-Africans may say, well, that's the white man's words. Europeans never had a language. Period. It comes from the word Slavic, which were the Russians captured by the Germans. Remember the movie Trading Places, when they switched places with them in the movie? This is all they have done with you, made you that, and them the ownership. And when you look at the dealing with the Atlantic Ocean, when people talk about this, the Atlantic slave trade, I don't even know what that is, but it was called the Ethiopic Ocean or the Ethiopian Sea. Why? Because they said the people that they seen over here, they seen in Ethiopia. The exact same people. I want y'all to look these people up. Do not take my word for anything that I'm saying here. There's a group of people. It's called the Afar people. I don't know if y'all familiar with these people. The Afar. And I want you to go online. Again, open that other window up. Open the other window up and look it up. And you'll see them. Go to images. You'll see them with locks like mine. It's the AFAR. AFR. The Afar people. The Afar people was actually the Kushites. Again, they were Kushites. There's a book out, and I want everybody to get it. It's called The Delaware Forgotten Folks. I'm going to repeat this again. The Delaware's Forgotten Folks. The Story of the Moors and Nanticos. I'm going to repeat this again. The Story of the Moors and Nanticos from Delaware by C.A. Weslinger. I'm going to spell his name out because I know it has to be a European. It's W-E-S-L-A-G-E-R. Weslinger. Good. Look it up. It's called The Delaware. Now, if anybody is familiar with the Sundry Free Act about the Moors, what I'm doing here, if you have a question, give me a call. This is your time. Do not wait until later. I'm just running these things down to show you something. The Nanticos, which you got your Nantucket, where they get those things from, they was actually called the Ephraimites. The Ephraimites. And I'm going to spell that for everybody. And I'm doing these things for a reason so you can look these things up. So when you see your scholars and they talk about Africans didn't have slaves. Yes, we did. Study your history. 1860, you had over 122 Negro slaveholders. I'm going to repeat this again. 1860 had 122 slaveholders, 190 slaves. And the so-called Negroes fought to keep their slaves. This is a fact. This is history, y'all. 1860. Look it up. I'm giving you records. So, you know, the reason why I brought this up, because my man came to me and said, a particular brother online, I think it was Renoka Rashidi, I don't know, he said that Renoka Rashidi was talking about how we weren't slaves and about the slave trade. Again, I'm not saying the slave trade did not happen, but we must study the language. The Ephraimite. So I'm going to spell it for everybody so they don't think I'm just making this stuff up. Get online. We have the computer now. The Ephraimite. Ephraimite. They were the Mandingo Moors who divided into several tribes. One tribe is called the Mandane, M-A-D-A-N, the Mandane, the Nantick, N-A-T-I-C-K. Now, this is in Delaware. Or the Nanticos. Those Ephraimites, which is the Cushites, the Moabites, all those people, right? Going back to the Afar people again. Remember, the Atlantic Ocean was called the Ethiopian Ocean or the Ifa Ocean. The Ethiopian Ocean before they called it the Atlantic Ocean, because they was talking about the people that they saw here looked just like the people over there. Let's go back for a minute. Bam. If you read the book, it will show you this information. Okay, so again, do not take Sabir's word for anything. I want you to research this information. And I I'm going to take a quick break. And I hope y'all sucked a lot of this up, because I'm going to come back with more of this information. But I want you to do your own research on this. And again, this is time now for you can go tell one of your scholars or whatever your friends are, whoever, or your Pan-Africans to say, look, this brother's only talking about we were already here. It's a fact. Don't get it twisted with religion. I am, number one, is not a religious person. I'm a spiritual being. Yes, you had some Moors that were Muslims and some were Jews and some were Christians. The same people that's from Ethiopia were Moors also. But you must study your history. Again, do not y'all be afraid. We only have an hour and a half, only an hour now for the show. So give us a call in the studio at 323-473-3100. We'll be right back. All right.
You see, really, I don't give a damn what you make think me. Be a badass. I'ma do what I'ma do. I'ma say what I'ma say. If you're a badass, you understand what I'm saying. Well, you better. Yeah.
I was born in these streets, raised in these streets, walked in these streets, talked by these streets, lived in these streets, hustled in these streets, arrested in these streets, protected by these streets. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of these streets, I shall not fear these streets, because I run these streets. And I paid my dues with borrowed pennies, and now I'm a bad man, not ashamed. I'm a bad man, yeah.
I'm a bad man. My life's begun. I stood on these blocks, wore hood on these blocks, got paid on these blocks, trade on these blocks, move in on these blocks, put out on these blocks. I've been around the block, been watched on these blocks. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of these blocks, I shall not fear these blocks. Cause I run these blocks, yeah. Pay my dues with broken names. Now I'm a bad man. Boy, yes I am. Not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. A bad man. I don't need and don't need no love. I'm a bad man.
I'm a bad man. Woo. That's my boy Robert Kelly. I ain't gonna lie. I love that song right there. I was like, I'm a bad man. I don't need your love. Yo, welcome back to the show, y'all. Somebody said I got a hell of a music selection. Yo, I know I do. But listen, I'm back in the studio. I'm sitting in the studio now with my brother. You on camera right now, bro. So whatever you're doing is gonna happen. Listen, you do not have to call us up in the studio and sit on the line and wait. You can go to Roku, iTunes, TuneIn, Aha, Live 365, Apple, many different ways you can actually go watch it. If you have a Mini Coupe, you can go listen to it, Mini Coupe, but do not look at it and drive at the same time. So again, y'all can give us a call in the studio. I don't know if y'all just tuning in, but we're talking about the so-called black scholars, how they're not teaching about who we are. But I've just actually had my man in the studio, Rick, because this conversation came up. Because he called me, and I myself really don't get into back and forth beef on Facebook. I tell people to call me on the show. I know by now everyone knows about my show now, and this is not new to me. It's, you know, it's old, but we've been doing this here for 3 years on LA Talk Live, so I know it's in circulations. I know there's no mistake, so y'all can give me a call in the studio if you doubt it. But my man Rick, you know, brought up about, what was that, Rick? Bro, go ahead, man. About you was talking about something on YouTube. About Facebook.
Facebook, and you know, I'm tagged in, or I follow Ronoko Rashidi, and he brought up a subject about the thing about whether or not so-called black peoples are the indigenous peoples of the Americas, and I said, you know, quite sure they are. Yes, if they was the first on the planet, and they populated the earth, then yes, they was the first. How can you be the first but the second to the land? That don't even make sense. So if you the first in the world, then you the first on the land mass. So then he said we should, you know, not get into that, and that's not, you know, taking away from them. And no, bro, that's our history.
Hold up, take it away from who?
Taking away from the so-called Native Americans.
Bruh, let me say this, and I'm going to interject real quick, because you said that. That's why I said I wanted you to be here. In this book by David Inhotep, he speaks about, and I talked about the Ephraimites, and how they were the Delaware Moors. And I hope he's listening to this, and I hope y'all can share this to Ronoko Rashidi. He can reach out to me. I'm on Facebook. I'm on Instagram. I don't care. I will go up against any of them. It doesn't matter. I know what they're doing. You know what I mean? So I know they watch what I'm, you know, these shows. I know they watch me, period. The problem is, we're not taking anything away from anybody. We are those indigenous people. Now, I just broke down the tribes. My family's from the Ainanua Wiat, which is, you would call the Cherokee tribe. And most of them may be Seminoles. They're the same people. They're Moors. The last name, let me repeat this again. The last name on the books for our people were Moors. I just picked up the book by Dr. Ben that all y'all like to follow, but it's too much to read. But Dr. Ben spoke of studying in Moor schools. Dr. Ben said this. Dr. Ben is an Ethiopian. Okay? So these are the things we really have to straighten it out. Like, again, I'm not saying slavery did not happen, but we have to study timelines. Okay, when we talk about timelines, they were not states back then. So when they were talking about bringing slaves into, first of all, that right there, the slave part, again, do not take Sabir's word for it. When they talk about bringing slaves into the country, the listening audience, I would like to know, what is the name of the country that they brought the slaves into? This critical thinking, analytical thinking. What was the name of the country that they brought the slaves in? I'll wait. 323-473-3100.
And not only that, and people fail to realize when they talking about 13 colonies, 13 colonies consisted of maybe 50 to 100 square miles, and that's it. We're not talking about the whole state.
Yeah, Mike, you got to come closer to the mic, brother. Yeah, because yeah, everybody keeps telling
me. We're not talking about a whole state of what they see today, or the whole republic of what they see today. We're talking about only 50 to 100 square miles. That's it. So it's not like they access the whole territory. They only access 50 to 100 square miles, and that was a colony.
Exactly. But let me say this, because my boy Anthony, man, he goes in on Friday, and we're going to continue this on Friday too, but I hope people give me a call into the studio if they, you know. But my man Anthony said the problem is that people don't want to be related to the Moors, and Moors get upset with me. Like I said, I don't care. I don't need your love. I don't need you for that. I'm telling the truth. It's about the truth. So some Moors get upset because I say it's not about a religion. It's not. I am not a religious being. I'm going to keep putting it out there. If you understand when I'm saying Islam means peace, Muslim means one who submit. I don't care if you say Muslim, Muslim. I understand language very well. I understand that. If you're a Christian, a Seventh-day Adventist, whatever you call yourself, the day of tomorrow, you submit your will to do the will of the Creator. That's it. That's all. Right? So when people, my brother Anthony said that the Moors, the problem is that the Moors keep pushing it as a religion. That's why nobody wants to be involved in it. It's who you are. And then you have the other people on the other. And this is what opens up the door for guys like Renoko Rashidi and them cats to come out and say what they're saying about people. You see what I'm saying? I am a scientist. I am a researcher. I am a historian. I'm not a religious being. So the ones that they may go to are the ones that may be in there that don't know too much or can't stand on their squares, you know, and challenge these people. Again, I'm going to repeat this so nobody can put on Facebook or whatever you YouTube, Sabir, I'm not a religious person. I'm a historian, number one. So when people hear this information, they hear it from one perspective. This is why I created this platform, so people can actually ask the questions openly on air. And I can give you my open, honest answer to everything that's going on. This is why I said I don't have a problem, you know, and it's not to beat up Renokos and the Aswakwazis and any of our other elder scholars, because I don't want people to think that. It's just that we need to sit down at a table and discuss this information. I give high honors to my brother, Professor James Smalls, or Dr. James Smalls now, because he asked me to help him with some information on the Moors. So I said I like that. And Brother Milana Karinga, who's actually doing a book on Noble Drew Ali, and I think he said Malcolm X. So when my elders say yo and humble themselves and say yo, Sabir, could you help us out, it's not a problem. You see what I'm saying? Majority of these people actually want people to follow them, and this is what's going on. So when Rick said this to me, I said, yo, man, I got to address this issue because I can't keep letting it go by the wayside. Let it happen.
Yeah, let me read some of the things.
Yeah, go ahead. Read some of that stuff, man. I hope he's okay, listening in, man.
I'm on this page right now, and he said, family, I'm troubled by assertions that seems to minimize the significance of the transatlantic slave trade. Much of this comes from sisters and brothers attempting to claim that Native Americans were, in fact, black people. They even run and go as far as to claim that the transatlantic slave trade was a hoax. To deny it is an insult of all of our ancestors that suffered through it. Also reduces our chances to receive reparation. Okay? And it also serves to distance ourselves from Africa. And that it can never be a good thing. Finally, much of the claim that the indigenous Americans were black peoples has little factual basis. Okay, let me address this. First of all, Mr. Renoko Rashidi, I've been following you since The Good Life. And what you will find in Noah Webster Dictionary, 1828, you will find the definition of what an American is. And if you look it up, the American, a true American is someone of copper color Aboriginal race. So if you put a penny on your skin and it matches, that's who they're talking about. Now, and also in that definition, it states that the so-called pale-skinned Europeans call themselves Americans now. So you have to do your research, brother. And our peoples are suffering from lack of knowledge. And if you're not doing your research, you might as well just walk away from it.
Listen, a brother shared with me, and shout out to my brother, Muhammad. He said to me, they got older but didn't get wiser. This is what he said to me. They got older but not wise. And I really hope Renoko is actually listening to this show, or y'all can tell him, hit him up right now, because I've literally seen this brother come at a brother that's an attorney, Kwaku Parson Lynn's son, and made this guy, because the brother raised the question, and again, I would love to sit on a panel with any of them. He raised the question about slavery. Did blacks have slaves? He said blacks and slaves, you know, blacks and slave blacks. This is what, first of all, we weren't black people. Let's clear that one up. Let's kill that noise. Let's kill that one right there. Let's kill that right now. It don't exist.
These labels that elude us.
Let me tell you this. Exactly. Let me see this. If, just imagine, y'all, if you started putting out there Morris Lives or Morris Lives Matter or Morris Period, what do you think would happen? Right now, I think the brother's name is Theo. I might hope I got your name right, brother. I think the name is Theo. I'm trying to remember off the top of my head off of Facebook. He said the reason why they're killing our brothers like crazy is because they know what time it is. Listen, Noble Drew Ali said he's going to make the European tell the truth. He also said he said three generations will come with their eyes wide open. Listen, they know exactly who you are. They know who you are. But what happens, you have a couple of paid off Negroes like today that's keeping up with this bull, and they're putting mad funds behind everything that is happening. Again, I had this discussion with a brother. You know, it's ongoing, and I told him I'm going to talk about him in the restaurant a couple of days ago. He said he was God, and we weren't all Moors. And I said, brother, well, you're not studying history. I just pulled out books. Crocs Cry Out, The First Africans. This is another good book by J.E. Rogers. Speaks about the Moors that was on a boat with Columbus in 1500s. So when we're talking about facts, we're not just telling you anything. We're telling you to research what we're saying to you. You see what I'm saying? And I know some people probably sitting up there scratching their heads right now, puzzled, and probably petrified to call in. Because what happens, you have cyberspace gangsters online who talks about this stuff and trying to get people hyped up. And you have no facts on anything that you're talking about. Again, we're not saying slavery didn't happen. I can speak for myself. Just for myself. I can't say it happened, but it happened. But we need to analyze these things. Look at why blacks have not, so-called blacks have not received any reparations. Think about it for a minute. Ask yourself the question, why haven't they? Ask yourself the question, why Obama's in Cuba talking about human rights violation when brothers are still constantly, actually got a brother got killed while he was in Cuba. So if you are an attorney or a constitutional attorney, why don't you understand what's going on? Or you misleading someone, or they in the Masonic lodges, or in the lodges hiding the light for the people who need the light. Think about it for a minute. The truth don't sell, and this is what is happening right now. So again, I'm gonna open up the phone lines again. 323-473-3100. Again, y'all, only on Tuesdays we have an hour and a half, but I will welcome any callers at any given time. But before, and I have to forewarn you, before you call this show, cross your T's, dot your I's, pull this information up. We are all the same people. We are Moors. Again, I don't know how many times Brother Taj and I actually put this information out to people and tell people, listen, we're all the same. We're all the same people. That's the last name on the book. We're Moors. That's it. So if you have any questions, give us a call. And I believe we have a caller right now. It says unknown, but maybe it's one of them. I don't know. Hold on 1 second. Gotta see where we at. Hold up. Put this on mute. Call, I see you right there. Call, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yes, peace. What's your name? What's your name? Where you calling from?
This is Piawe Ali, calling from Atlanta.
Peace, brother. What's going on?
I think I may have a delay in your video feed.
You might be. You watching it? That's what it is.
Is it? Say it again.
I said maybe. It may be.
Cool, man. I'm actually sitting out here waiting for the great field class to start at 7 o'clock, but I wanted to ask the question about the actual differentials between the two flags, the Al-Moroccan flag and the Kingdom of Morocco flag, and why is it that we have the Kingdom of Morocco flag on all of our paperwork that's drafted up for doing nationalization and declaration of standing ETC?
Let me explain this to you real quick, brother, and it's for the listening audience. I don't subscribe to any of those things. You follow me? I can rock the flag. I understand the history, but I am a more regardless whether it's a flag or not a flag. You see what I'm saying? What people have to understand and study history. The Kingdom of Morocco may be in Morocco. It's not ran by us. Let's be realistic. It's not ran by us anymore. Egypt is not ran by us no more neither. So again, I could care less about that flag. I can say I'm Ethiopian today, which I am the original. I could be that and rock a Ethiopian flag. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
But my thing is, like, I don't put any of those things on my documents. I don't know if you just tuned in, but I am me. I speak it. You see them to existence. When I did paper, when people talk about their paperwork, I never had paperwork done with me. You see what I'm saying? When I first did it, it was on one sheet of paper with Ty's signature. I still remember this, over 15 years ago. Ty's signature, Gene Ill, and Kamar Gabriel. One sheet of paper. And me, overstanding the language and overstanding the law, I issued those things to these places and had them corrected on every document that I had. You see what I'm saying? It's you that's knowing the law and the history. Paperwork doesn't make you. They can tear that piece of paper up today or tomorrow. You see what I'm saying? For me, you know, I can rock that flag. I can rock any flag if I choose to. But what happens, most people get caught up in saying that, this is the Moorish flag. No, whatever it is, you know what I mean? But they don't recognize you as being that over in Morocco. I know some brothers from Amazigh, which is really called, is Morocco. That's what it's called, the Amazigh, and the people's called the Imazigh. So once you start understanding the languages and start traveling and building with other people, go outside of what you've been studying. Most people don't do that. So again, brother, I just tell people, proclaim who you are, be who you are. That's it. No one can tell you who you are. But one thing's for sure, that Noble Drew Ali said, that we were not Negro, Black, and Colored people. You follow me?
Right.
That's
right.
One thing's for sure. We are not that. There is not a Black nation. There's not an African-American nation. I heard cats say, well, is there a Moorish nation? Yeah, you have to look at it. Is it really? Is it really? I have to, you know, and I'm going to be honest. Is it really? But I'm a Moor. But I'm going to link to my nation. But as a collective, as an umbrella, that's what he was saying, as we are all Moors. There is no human family on this planet called Negro, Black, and Colored. And those who know this keep us in the dark. Those who know what time it is keep us in the dark. Some of them are paid off. Some of them stopped their growth. But right now, why things are happening is because our people becoming conscious to what's going on. This information is global, brother. I've been in a lot of places. Half the people be shocked because they know I'm sitting somewhere. And they be like, oh, he's here. Let's ask the question. And I explain it to anybody. This is just me because I am a researcher. But as far as the flag, brother, I don't rock a kingdom.
If I can address that, because I know it's really pitted in the back of your mind addressing the issue with the flag and what you do, you can find that information. Well, if you study your 101s, you'll find that it's there. And then if you also study and research the history of the Moroccan Empire flag, and then you'll know that they just barely adopted that flag in '50.
Yeah, 19.
With a five-pointed star on it. They had a blank star. They had a blank flag without the star. And then once they realized they had the wrong one, and then they had to address that issue with the right one.
Well, that's true.
So do your research, brother.
And that's what I was trying to get them to do the research. What Brother Rick just said, I experienced that because I used to work at a pizza spot with brothers from Tunisia and Morocco, and we that argument, and I don't waste my time with the arguments with them no more. See what I'm saying? Because it's like, I know what they're being taught. I know what the Ethiopians are being taught and the Somalians being taught when they come in. Don't talk to the Negroes. This is what happens. Don't talk to those Negroes. Right. Don't tell them anything. But because of the way this information in the internet is now, everybody are becoming conscious. And that's why I said, do not take my word for it. Do your research on this information. And we always prove this.
I've done the research, and I'm totally with you as far as them adopting it after the fact. My issue was, Kingdom, my understanding is that kingdom is subordinate to empire.
Yeah.
So if that is so, and there is a distinct difference between what is supposed to be the Al-Moroccan flag, which is the empire, and the Kingdom of Morocco flag, even though there's similarities, there's a distinct difference. Why do we have the Kingdom of Morocco flag posted on our paperwork? Because it was actually a brother from Casablanca that schooled me. At a Whole Foods.
See?
That's how I first found out about it a year ago.
See, and this is what happens, brother. And I'm glad you brought that up, because Moors are pushing that. You see what I'm saying? That's why I said, you heard me say, I can rock any flag I choose to rock. You see what I'm saying? I know what time it is, but the argument would be what you just went through, and it has to be somebody coming in to tell you certain things, even though they may have been colonized too. But again, a flag does not define me. You follow me? Even though I know it represents a nation, the whole empire. You have Asia Minor, right? Let's be realistic. Let's use this for a minute. You have Asia Minor, right? Right?
Right.
So when you're dealing with minority, majority, you have to have a majority, right? If you have a minority, right? Right?
If you have
a minority in something, it has to be something else. Come on.
I mean, minority isn't referring to numbers. It's
No. I got all that. I'm just saying, if you have a minority, you got to have a majority, or vice versa, right? If you have a minor something, right, where would be the major at? Where's the major? Think about it. They only teach you about Asia Minor, right? Right?
Gotcha.
So where's the major? Now, my brother that did this book right here, When Rocks Cry Out, Horace Butler, he explained some things. Actually, this book right here, The First Americans Were Africans, he explains it in here, right? But our scholars are not teaching this. But again, I just don't take what people say. I tear everybody's book apart, and I never read a full book. I am a researcher. So again, if I understand what Asia Minor mean, which we are the original Asiatics, because the most honorable Elijah Muhammad used to say it a lot. And Noble Drew Ali said we are Asiatic, right? So if we're talking about Asia, which is a landmass, right? You have to have a major somewhere. So the major that we're talking about, we're standing in it right now, that we call Northwest Semexum. Now, to go a little further than this, in Philadelphia, where I grew up at, there's on Delaware Avenue, or again, going back to the Delawares again, Christopher Columbus has a statue, but on the street it says Amexum. Amexum. Right? On Delaware Avenue. We're in Northwest Amexum.
What country?
It's in Philadelphia.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, right down where they built the casino at. And so if any of my Philadelphia family that's looking, go down to the Delaware Avenue where the casino at, and you're going to see the street called Amexum down there. It's not a mistake that they put that there. So once you start studying it for yourself, you will actually get it.
Even in some of the movies, like I watched Glory the first time, and then I studied Glory, and then I started dissecting the movie Glory. And in the movie Glory, they doing a march scene, and they trying to get the regiments, the brothers in the regiment to march right. And he started calling them Mexicans, Hindus, this, that, and the other, because he was confused on who was who. And in one of the battle scenes, they go into this one town, and they holding a flag. I can't remember which flag they was holding, but on that flag it show a dark skinned person on that flag, representing that republic. So those are some of the things. When you look at some of these movies, you have to dissect. You got to look at every inch of the movie scene to understand where they're coming from. And even in the Republic of California, all the ELs and the ALs are Arabic. And if you do the definition breakdown of EL and AL, like out here we have El Segundo, El Monte, Alameda. Those are Arabic names that our peoples gave the so-called Spaniards.
Brother, you got a lot of noise in your background, brother. Wherever you at, you got a lot of noise in your background.
So, you know, you gotta break down where you live at and ask yourself, why is this name that and why is this name this? And do that major breakdown.
I had to hang up with the brother because he had a lot of stuff in his background. But anyway, let me read from this book right here. This is a good book, man. And he talks about the Hopi. According to their legends, the Hopi, or, you know about the Hopis, Brother Joe? Hopi? The Hopi, right? Yeah, turn on the mic. The Hopi Indians, right? It speaks about the Hopi Indian that's in Mexico and what they look like in here. And it was from the Dogon family. I'm sitting here like, yo, this is like they're telling you. But again, our so-called black scholars will never talk about this to our people. But again, we are doing more damage to keep our people enslaved than any of the Europeans have ever done. I'm just keeping it real. You know, again, this is not Sabir just making up stuff or going online and finding things. You have to do your research, okay? So let me go back to this caller. Hopefully he has... Yes, brother. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm using Skype, man.
Okay, brother. A question or comment, because we're going to keep it moving and open up the phone lines for other people at 323-473-3100. What's going on?
No, I was just on the phone with you, and the call dropped.
I know, because it was a lot of stuff going on in your background, so I had to let it go, because people are complaining about stuff that's going on in the background. So that's why I tell people, if you go somewhere where it's quiet, that you can, so everybody won't hear somebody cursing somebody out in the background. All right?
Copy that, man.
All right? So any other questions you want to ask?
Not right now, brother. Thanks.
All right. Listen, we only have another half an hour, y'all, on the line. So give us a call at 323-473. Or better yet, y'all, call some of your scholars up. Tell them to call the show. Please call them. I'm telling you, because people like to wait. I be getting off the air sometimes, and I'm seeing the phone lines light up, and I'm like, really? Like, I'm off the air. Like, I think they do it purposely sometimes so that they can say, yo, we called the show, and we didn't get in. But here's your opportunity. I am running the boards right now. Sabir is running the boards right now. So there's no excuses that you could not get in. All right? So we're discussing about our so-called scholars. And again, I brought my brother Rick in because Rick was in here talking about how this brother, Renoka Rashidi, was saying he is appalled or whatever other stuff that he was talking about.
That we trying to steal somebody else.
We trying to steal somebody.
History.
Listen, let me say this real quick. Y'all stealing somebody else's history. Why are you, most, and I'm not saying him, but I'm pretty sure it's, you know, majority of these brothers run around with European names anyway. So you're stealing somebody else's history and culture too. Why you dress like them? Why you eat like them? Why you think like them? Think about it for a minute. We talk all this stuff, but we stealing. No, if you studied history, and in Philadelphia, or the Philadelphias, okay, where the gallery at on Market Street was actually a native land on that whole area. And I remember when they was building it back in, I think it was the 80s. I think it was late 80s or something like that. They used to cover it up. When they start covering things up and you can't see in, it's something that's dug there. Because City Hall is 13 stories up off the original ground. People don't understand that. It's 13 stories up off the original ground. So when they were digging, they were picking up pots and picking up bones and stuff like that. Who were there? You know what the Negroes would say? Oh, they were slaves. Not even understanding what they were a slave mean. Mummer's Day Parade means silent mockery. That's what mum means. Like, mum's the word. Silent mockery. You see what I'm saying? So when you start doing your research, not going on what one book says, because that's what most of them go by, one particular book. I just pulled out one, two, three. Actually, I ain't even show this book right here. I got to show this one, but I don't like the title of it, though, but it's all good. By Lerone Bennett. Good book. Speaks about the Moors in here too. There is no difference. Those people that they're talking about were Moors. This is why I said I'm not here to change your mind on anything. I'm here to shift it. Just start asking the questions about the Moors. Stop saying the Moors, and they'll say the Moors enslaved Africans. Well, the damn Africans were Africans. The Moors were Africans. Like, that don't even make sense to me. It's like Moors enslaved Africans.
You know, either they'll say More means black.
That's another thing. They say more means black.
I agree with you. More means black. So what is what is a black or more? A black or black?
Exactly. It means black, black. Think black, about it for a minute. People black, help me. Educated people out there. Crazy. Call us in the studio. Insane. Does it mean black, black?
Yeah, black or black.
If more means black, I'm saying black, black.
Yeah. I'm saying really? That don't even make sense. You know,
this for all the
they
scholars.
Don't even understand half of the things they be trying
you know,
to
listen, listen,
defend.
Rick, I might get in trouble by some of these elders, but what the hell? You know? But they say I might get in trouble, boy. But anyway, they can give me a call in the studio. My line, listen, I'm open, dude. I am not tied to anything or anybody. Let's take this caller. Caller, welcome to the show. What's your name and where you calling from?
Caller. Hey, peace, brother. It's Mike from Philly.
Peace, Mike. What's going on, man? I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm trying to figure out this Atlantic slave trade thing and all that. I don't know. You got listen. They got listen, Mike. They got me drinking right now. I have to drink. See, I'm literally drinking, but I'm drinking a non-alcoholic beverage. See, they got me drinking right now because I'm trying to figure it out. Go ahead, man.
Yeah, you know that's crazy. But I wanted to build on you about the whole Philadelphia thing. How do you see how they cover up? I mean, they building, they tearing up Market Street right now.
Mm.
And they got the whole block covered. You know what I'm saying? They got walls up, everything, the tarp.
Wow, you serious? I mean, listen, people don't know history. In Philadelphia is where our nationalities were taken at, an Independence Mall. I was born and raised in Philly. I did not know what happened at that particular time. I heard a fool say one day, the Moore saying the Fed, the Liberty Bell was an inside-out Feds. I heard Moore say that. I don't know how true it is. You know, but for people who to speak on the Moore's history, you can't. Majority of these Pan-Africans, I don't care if it's one of your scholars, you cannot speak on the Moors until, a Moor until you sit with a skilled or a seasoned Moor who knows the history. You can't speak on it because you have a lot of people who are trying to speak on the Moor's history and know nothing about it, but going right back to the black thing. My brother Joe is in the studio right now. When people, if I asked him, or go to somebody from Mexico, you can't call these people black. They don't call themselves black. Even the people from Cape Verde don't like the word black. And Cape Verde is an island where they stopped off at before they got here. Talk to a Cape Verdean that's in New York. They don't use the term black. And it's not that they're running from the term black. It's like, oh, I don't want to be black. No, it's not that. And this is the ignorance that go out. You know, they just don't want to be black. Yeah, who does? When you know what the hell it is. This is why they're shooting black people. You follow me? Listen, let me do this real quick. Just imagine, right? Globally, again, remember I told you, put the clean glass up against the dirty glass. Just imagine if people just start putting out, they are killing Moors. Mind you, they're killing Moors globally, right? What do you think that would do? What do you think? Human rights start coming up. Other nations start coming in. You follow me? Because now you're creating a stink globally. And the people who know who the Moriscos, the Moranos, the Maroons, the Morays are in their language. You see what I'm saying?
Moro.
Or the Moro.
In
see what I'm saying? In the Philippines.
Yep.
The Moro. M, look it up. M-O-M-O-R-O. Moro.
Moro.
Go look it up.
I even saw that. It was an article I read a couple weeks ago. It said a cop was harassing an Asian national.
And I bet you he ain't harassing them no more. I bet you that dude probably fired. If he did, if it push came to shove, I bet you he's fired. But let me go a little further than this. But thanks, brother. You have anything else you want to share?
No, that's it. Just keep up the good work.
Give thanks, man. Yo, give us a call, man.
Let's get back.
Hold up. Give us a call real quick. 323-473-3100. Again, we only got like a half an hour probably, man, but I hope y'all get in contact with Renoko Rashidi. But I'm going to read something off that I found in the archives in D.C. It said, will Spain fall once before the Moorish tribes that conquered her in 711? Right? It's kind of beat up article. Sabir didn't make it up. 1938. Let me go a little further down on the bottom. So those doubt sayers that don't, they keep saying the Moors are not us. Okay? The Moors was originally were a nomadic tribe, which means people that moved from place to place, right? From Berbers and Hamitites of northern Africa. They were dark-skinned, sometimes almost black. I don't think they got that one right there. I don't think they got that, Rick, right there.
But
so
even,
we didn't make
it up. Even when you go into the Carolinas Negro Act, it tells you, it distinguished the difference between a so-called black person, a Negro, a Moor, and a Berber. Mm-hmm. You know, everything relating to being a Moor is freedom. Everything related to being colored, black, Negro, or whatever else they're going to call you, relates to being a slave or a Slavic person. So, listen, you know, and they always talk about, you know, more this and more that, but everything relates to more, it relates to freedom.
Exactly. But again, I hope they're listening, because I'm really getting tired of going back and forth, and my brother's coming to me telling me they're upset because these cats is out here, and they give these cats the platform to actually put out this propaganda, this bull. I don't, like I said, I'm not saying slavery again. I'm going to repeat this again because people take sound bites. I'm not saying slavery did not exist, but we are more enslaved, if you want to use that word, today than we have ever been with the computers. We're more enslaved. Okay, so I just wanted to put that out there, and I hope, again, we only got a half an hour. Y'all give us a call in the studio. Do not be afraid. I do not like to read the comments that I see on these places, and then act like you do not know about this show. 323-473-3100. But we're going to take a quick break. I got to go into my brother, Black Dot. Actually, my man from Turtle Gang, Nars. Shout out to my man from Turtle Gang. He always, you know, the brother's on fire. My man Nars is on fire, brother. He know. He loves going at these cats too, but they don't deal with our history. You gotta study the Lenape also, which is the original people. But sit back, relax, y'all. Give us a minute. But give us a call in the studio. 323-473-3100. This is my man Black Dot. Listen up to this song about how he said the Moors will be bringing the ride. Out is Now I Know.
Break beat Flores, ultimate breaks and beats. The way I was raised, you only held accountable for what you know. Check it, they try to tell me the original man, he wasn't born on this indigenous land. I give them pilgrims a hand, they be resilient when they're building the plan. I got the skills to rebuild the scam, so here I am. It's more of science, and the more you apply it, the more these devils find it hard to deny. The more they won't even try it, the more they won't be stealing deeds and hide it, because the Moors will be bringing the riot. Check it. They try to tell me that Osama was guilty for 9/11. They got filthy rich and bombed him to heaven. He wasn't on, I was alone because they killed him and killed all his brethren. They set him at sea so nobody can see. They said Obama's not a citizen. Shit is in disarray because they got innocent immigrants living in fear every day. They be shivering and slipping these bitter politicians, and they be getting them to work for lesser pay. They try to tell me that the earth is alone in the universe, but we're the first to burst upon it, to use it to birth the component. The moment that we surface, we knew we can work it, it serves its purpose, though these devils try to hurt it. They try to tell me they're no alien beings, but I'm the only alien they be seeing. But I ain't scary and green, the melanin be having scary and fleeing, because they fear that I'll appear in their dreams. Boom. They try to tell me serve the God of my enemy, scarring and killing me. Then they tell me God is a friend of me. Honestly, is it me? Do I need to honor my enemies? Deities who doing rituals to sop up my energy. They try to tell me that the voodoo that you do is doo-doo, but who do you call when the voodoo that you do is all you ever perform? Now they tell you that voodoo is wrong, but I better strong and my cuckoo to mention at all. They tell my children that it's Adam and Eve, then Adam and Steve, but they don't say the Adam and we. It's adamantly divine, so the Vatican be just backing the priest and lying and attacking our seeds. They try to tell me that the balance of life can be preserved without me having a wife. I'm here to challenge the hype. I speak the truth, I'm not the arrogant type. You in the dark, I'm here to carry the light. Check it. They try to tell me that nobody is living in 2012, so you gotta be kidding. Too many dealt with a cosmic opinion, but who the hell knows the proper intentions of the Mayans and what they forgot to mention.
Woo, that's my man Black Dot, dude. Listen, that boy is no joke. It's called Now I Know. You heard what he said. The Moors will be bringing the right. So don't get it twisted, y'all. Listen, y'all got only a couple more minutes to give us a call in the studio. But again, this is for all the doubt sayers. I just hope they listen to this, and I hope they call up. But I hope y'all tweet this out to them. But I'm going to take this moment for a minute to read off something from J.A. Rogers. And J.A. Rogers wrote his books in 1920s before there was any of these so-called scholars that you see out here today. And they don't never big up J.A. Rogers. And what I love about his books, as this book right here called Nature. Nature knows no color line. All right. He speaks about, in the Italian dictionary, says Moreau, with brother Rick, you know what you just said, Moreau. He said, or it says Moreau. I might be pronouncing this word wrong. Umo Nero Diatep. Diop. I'm going to spell it because it's kind of, I don't know if it's Amharic or what, but it's U-O-M-O-N-E-R-O-D. I know Ethop. I know that's Ethiopia, but it's Ethop. So it means black man of Ethiopia. That's what it says. And a Century Dictionary says Moor means blackamoor, right? Go down a little further. It speaks about, in France, the Ethiopians are spoken of as Moors, very black. I'm going to repeat this again for everybody. In France, the Ethiopians are spoken of as Moors, very black. So what is the argument, Rick? So where's the Renokos at talking about that? Black was the adjective, right? So you can't say black, black.
You can't say black or black.
Black is an adjective. I had people trying to make sense out of everything. We going to reverse it. No, dude, listen. Understand etymology, y'all. Etymology or idiomon or the etymon of the origins of words. Let's go a little further than this because I'm explaining that word blackamoor also. And actually, we was the Druids too. The Druids. Let's go a little further. Variations of the word moor. You can spell moor. M-A-U-R-E. M-O-O-R-I-S-H. Maury, like as in Maury Povich. M-A-U-R-Y. Or Moran. Moran, M-A-U-R-I-N. Martinez, Moran again, M-O-R-A-N. Or M-O-R-A-N-D. Moor, M-O-R-E. There's many different variations, man. So it's M-O-R-O-T or M-O-R-I-Z-E. It depends on where you at. So they're still referring to the Moors, no matter which way you're looking at it. So when you see these Latino brothers that we keep talking about, they're Moors also. We have to understand this. Don't get it twisted. The word Mexican means mix. That's all it means, which means mix from who? The indigenous people and the Spanish people. Okay? You only replace the E with an I, like an N, I-N, or E-N. Same exact thing. So they're still Moors. This is all it is. And it was funny because, you know, I go online sometimes, and I know some people may know or remember the story of Different Strokes. I don't remember that story, Different Strokes, Rick. Like, you remember the TV series, Different Strokes, right? Remember when Arnold used to sit down, he used to talk to a fish?
Yes.
What kind of fish was it? Do you remember what fish it was?
No, I don't.
This
remember
is how I tell you, analyze a movie. I mean, TV set, huh?
I don't remember the fish.
You remember the fish he used to sit down and talk to when he got in trouble? You remember, Joe?
No,
Different Strokes with Arnold and Willis.
Nah, I didn't get to see it.
Okay, I want y'all to go online and look up this. Probably punching Different Strokes. Different Strokes. The father was watching over the sons, which is a Mason. The two boys were Moors. Okay, the storyline. The fish that Arnold used to talk to was called a blackamoor fish. Go online right now, y'all. Go look up the word. Go look up a blackamoor fish. Look up the fish. You'll see it. They call it a goldfish today. But it's the blackamoor fish that Arnold used to talk to, and the fish was called Abraham. Go look it up. Don't take my word for it.
And for our and for our so-called Hispanic brothers and sisters, For some of your so-called Hispanic brothers and sisters, or Latino brothers and sisters, or whatever label they placed on you as well, if you do a research on Moorish names in Mexico, you'll find out that some of the names like Salazar, Marino, Laura, those are all Moorish names. So they connecting you but telling you something different. So if you take the time and research and find out that, you know, you have a name like Salazar or Laura, L-A-R-O, or Lore, L-A-R-A, or Marino, which means dark-skinned people, I mean, they're telling you exactly who you are, but you don't take notice to it. So you need to, do your research. Research your own name. Research your territory. Research some of these streets they got. Research some of the cities they done named. Like out here in California, we got the Alhambra, right? Mm-hmm. We got Granada Hills,
yeah.
Right? We got Marino Valley.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to research these things. They're telling you exactly where you at. So you home. The only immigrants are those who came over here call themselves Europeans.
Yep.
Those are only immigrants here. So we need to stop looking at one another as immigrants and so-called slaves, because they are the slaves and they are the immigrants. So we got to give them back their descriptions of us and take on our titles and defend what is actually ours, which is under our feet. So, you know, we got a lot of work to do.
Listen, we only got a couple minutes, y'all. Hit us up in the studio, 323-473-3100. I would like to hear from you. Hit us up in the studio. Again, do not wait till the last minute to... Yeah, and that's what kills me, man. Everybody got a... It's like a Lauryn Hill song, right? Lauryn Hill said they got so much to say. So much to say when you on these social media. And I want to thank Joe, because I know for sure that people are getting this. You see what I'm saying? They're getting it, but yet you want to backlash it and say, well, yeah, he don't know what he's talking about. But if I don't know what I'm talking about, y'all, please call me in the studio. But we're going to clear this up. Stop running around here. I will not debate with somebody who is not on my level of debating. But if you want to call the show, you can. Or if you got a couple of grand, then I will sit and debate with you. But for right now, it's not even about that. It's about, listen, setting the record straight on who we are. Because a lot of these so-called black leaders and black scholars out here not telling our people who they are. I don't know why. You know, I don't sometimes like to be the troublemaker inside the room. You know me, but I hear a lot of this stuff and I try not to... But I'm not a typing dude. I don't type back and forth, you know what I mean, and go word for word on Facebooks and Twitter or Instagram. My thing is like, listen, I'm going to present the facts to you and let you choose. That's just how hip hop is also. So again, I see you can call me on the shows on Friday or you can call me on the shows on Tuesday. And this is your opportunity right now before we get off the air to call me up. And I hope y'all reached out to Renoka Rashidi to ask him, why is he not telling our people the truth about who we are? Why are we not talking about how we were, you know, how in denying that we had slaves? You see what I'm saying? Why are you denying it? The problem is we have to tell the truth around the board. Why do you think blacks are not getting reparations? Who would you... Let's think about reparations for a minute. What nation would you give it to? What nation would you get it from? But yet, everybody operates on this emotional tip. Oh yeah, they're doing blacks wrong. Yeah, they're killing their property. They can do what they want. And if you study the Dred Scott case, and I tell everybody this, hit me up on my email. We try to get it out there to you. The Dred Scott case talks about what they can do to their own property. It speaks about that in there. But you can email me at info@thesabirabayshow.com. Again, that's info@thesabirabayshow.com. Again, a lot of stuff I do not like to address, because you have a lot of people already addressing issues that's really, to me, is irrelevant. Because if you're not talking about nation building or nationality, it really doesn't mean anything to me right now, because this is where it's at. They know that. You just don't know that. You are Hiram, who have been knocked in your head and knocked unconscious. That's what the real deal is right now. You are Hiram. This is why that judge bangs that mallet 3 times. You've been knocked in your head and knocked unconscious. So they're going to keep paying off more and more so-called black leaders to keep our people asleep. Somebody brought up, well, what about Ivan Van Sertima? Ivan Van Sertima knew very well who we were, but they never talked about our people being here. We are the original Ethiopians that's here. We are the original Nanakos, Choctaws, Blackfoots, all these people here. Even William Penn in 1681, quoting from David MacRitchie. Actually, Dr. Inhotep quotes, I believe Dr. Inhotep quotes David MacRitchie. Look up David MacRitchie, Ancient and Modern Brits. I'm going to repeat this again for everybody. And tell Renoko to get that book too.
And also tell Renoko Rashid to get William Penn books. And William Penn gives descriptions on what he saw when he was inside the villages and stuff like that, on what the indigenous peoples look like and what they feel.
And they weren't black.
You know, and they wasn't
they weren't never, black. Never not called, black like he's saying.
He never called them by some adjective. He called them by the particular
their tribal
nation.
Names. Hey, I wish my brother Norris would call in, man, because Norris he kills them on it, man. But again, he didn't say black.
No.
Okay. But also, let me say this. William Penn in 1681 spoke of the black tinklers. I believe tinklers, I'm going to see if it's on the top of my head. It's T-I-N-K-L-E-R. Tinkler. Spoke of the black tinklers to be as black as gypsies. That's what he said at the time frame. 1681, to be as black as gypsies. But again, we're using the word black as an adjective. We just gave the noun. You see what I'm saying? So when you start understanding the language again, you will understand what's going on. So they were still talking about our people that were already here. And then in Hollywood, some things in Hollywood, they do tell the truth. But because you're looking at these people as Indians, which we call GI Indians, which is government Indians, we don't call them the real, and they're not Indians. We are the original indigenous people,
that's
indigo people.
That's the image. That's another county, Indio County. I mean, come on, Indio.
Indigo
county.
Means dark anyway. Regardless, it means dark.
And that's another image they want to burn.
Call, I see you on the line.
Burn physically into your mind is the fact that these pale skinned so called Native Americans are been here forever, and
they the mixed breeds.
Yeah, they the mixed breeds.
But listen to this. Hold on. I was going into the market yesterday. I saw two brothers from Hindustan. Mm-hmm. So when I'm walking in the market with them, y'all should do this sometimes. Do it. Talk to somebody from Ethiopia and say Habesha, from Abyssinia, and watch what they say. They're going to say, are you Habesha? But these two brothers, four was from India, and I said, oh, you from Hindustan? He said, no, India. I said, no, Hindustan, right? He said, yeah. I said, from Sri Lanka? He said, yeah. How did you know? No lie, I put my arm against his. He was darker than me. I said, you from Sri Lanka? He said, how did you know? I said, because that's the Moors that's down. He started smiling. You follow me? Once you understand the history, they'll be building with you, but they're not told to talk to black people when they come here. But let's take this call, because I don't want to have my call on the line. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Well, this is Mark L. from Fort Wayne, Indiana.
Peace, brother. What's going on, man?
I'd like to add about the great show today as well.
Thanks, man.
I'd like to add the dress, Scott, you just brought up.
Yeah.
Last night, I was watching the movie Higher Learning.
Wow.
And in the movie, Omar Epps' character does an essay on dress Scott and says it directly in the movie about the importance of status. And I just, it blew me away. You know, it just lets you know when you're studying this science and you get on the right frequency, it'll line up.
It'll line straight up, dude, because the Dred Scott case said, this is what it states in there, the descendants of those Africans, it didn't say everybody, it said of those Africans who were imported into this country and sold as slaves could not be citizens under the word citizens in the Constitution. It didn't say all of them. It said those that was imported into this country. So they're telling you there's a difference. Understand those people. That it's not everybody. It's not the group of everybody. Is it those that was brought here as slaves, whether emancipated or not, could not be citizens within the meaning of the Constitution. Now, what they have done is create a second-class citizenship for these people. Look it up. They created a second-class citizen to be protected property under the 14th Amendment. Mm-hmm. This is why you have the president can create or pass a legislative order or executive order in the territorial zone. So when people, you just brought it up. Now, let me run this down before our time is up. You got three. You're going in courts. Right. And I don't like to use this analogy, but it's courts. In court, you have status, jurisdiction, and adjudication. I'm going to repeat this again. Status, jurisdiction, adjudication. Before you can get jurisdiction over anything or anybody, you have to have what first? The status first. Then you get the jurisdiction. Then you can adjudicate.
Right.
Any of my attorneys out there that's listening, they know what it is. But again, if any of these cats are constitutional attorneys, they supposed to know these things are happening. This is why they can keep gunning our brothers down in these streets. Again, reverse it.
Consistently,
Reverse it and say that they're killing Moors. Killing Moors. Let's keep reversing that. They're killing Moors on the street and see what happens. Okay? That's what we need to start doing. All right?
All right, thank you.
Yes, sir. Give thanks, man.
Is that brother still there?
Yeah, he's still on the line.
Yeah, tell him to, I always reference myself back to the movie Glory. I mean, in that scene where they're marching, listen to what the dude says. He calls them Mexican, you Mexican African, you Hindus, you this, you that. And then when they go into that one city and raid those, where they got the contraband type soldiers, and they holding the Delaware flag. Really look at the Delaware flag. It's a dark-skinned brother on the flag.
All day.
The Morris coats of arms.
I mean, take your time and dissect that movie.
Coat of arms.
And look at it again.
Listen, man. I did this show because of this brother here, and I said, because I really don't. All my shows, you can probably go to the archives and watch all my shows, man. I touch it on in between here, but the thing is that it's no. There is no money in the truth. I'm telling you this, brother. And I tell people that I did radio for like 12 or 13 years. And I literally had to go get my own sponsors to keep this thing going for. And I sometimes I get disgusted and put and pissed off because I'm like,
yes,
they're not getting it. But it is reaching right. some people. You know what I mean? It's reaching some people. But listen, I want to mm-hmm. say this. Thank you, brother. Thanks a lot for calling in, man. Hopefully, I'll be in Indiana real soon because I'm working on a lecture tour with J.A. Rogers. And I'm breaking down everything.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, I'm working on a lecture.
Okay.
But you can go to my website, www.thesabirbayshow.com. Okay. Actually, I did quite a few DVDs with Leonard Jeffries, James Smalls, Dr. Cobb, Booker T. Who else I did it with? Brother Todd. It's called the Elder Series, and it's on my website.
Okay.
But I'm okay. doing that purposely to show the connection between us and them, but how we're the same people. So, and if anybody want to donate, they can go to info@thesabirbayshow.com. They want to donate to the show. It's very welcome. Mm-hmm. If you have anything you want to sponsor,
yes.
you want to advertise, please reach out. Again, that's info@thesabirbayshow.com. Or you can just purchase some DVDs. You can download some of them. And again, I always say share these shows out to everybody. I have other shows that's up there online that people can go on and look up. I know a lot of people look at these shows and with a keen eye, boy, try to see where did he slip up at. You know, how could we put him in his box?
Yeah, all day.
Oh, I know they do, brother. Believe me, I've been doing this for a minute. Uh-huh. I know who listens to these shows. And again, they just leave crazy comments or crazy stuff on YouTube, but never, ever hit me in present.
Ever.
Okay?
Right.
So give thanks, family. All right?
All right, now.
Peace and love. All right, peace. You know, yeah, see what I'm saying? But that's what people got to do. Again, I want people to start doing their own research. Mm-hmm. Do not take anything I say at face right. value here,
and,
man.
And how much time we got left?
You got to talk up loud. We got 3 minutes,
how much time we got? We got 3 minutes. Okay, let me touch on that brother I had mentioned.
A minute, brother.
Liberty Bell, okay? And if you take the crack of the Liberty Bell and that dot on the crack is actually the map of the Mississippi River, and that actual dot on that crack of that bell is a place on Mississippi called Cairo.
Hey, listen, so I told you.
Do your research. Don't
listen.
You know,
you better get this book. You better get this book called When Rocks Cry
research.
Out. This is a good book right here, man. This brother Horace Butler laid it out.
Oh, yes.
Peru,
yes.
Which is Haru.
See the book.
Peru, Haru.
Do my selfie.
So listen.
For brother Horace Butler, let him know I represent your book. DuPont right. Noble
no,
Bay
but this is,
representing your book. And the brother got a lot
you gotta
of
speak it to the mic, brother. You
the brother gotta, got a lot of information in this small book.
Yeah.
And if you don't read it, you need to read it. And it's real important that you do read it. And the brother also is on Facebook
yeah.
breaking down some more science.
Yeah.
The brother's dynamic.
So listen, again, we did this hour and a half. We're going to continue to get on Friday. Everybody stay tuned. We do the hip hop lessons on Friday. But my co-host, brother Anthony, is always like fire with him because I like it because he'll say things to trigger me and I'll say things to trigger him. So we'll go back and forth. So again, we laid it out. Replay this, retweet it out to everybody. Listen, I'm so sick of going back and forth with this with people, but listen, I had to do it because I got tired of these cats keep saying the Moors enslaved Africans and blah. I said, we enslave each other right now in 2015. All these brothers and sisters who work for these government institutions, it's the exact same thing as this modernized. That's about it. But again, I want to thank everybody for tuning into the show. I told you, please do not call me at the last minute. Our time is up right now, but I want to thank my man Joe for always tweeting things out. Shout out to my Mexican brothers and sisters who listens to this show. Listen, tweet it out. Tell a friend. Deal with Facology. You will never defeat it. You know what I mean? I want to thank my man Rick for coming in. I want to thank my whole squad, always. Jessica Abraham Hogan, Anya Bay, Karen McGee, Alberto, my man Sal, DJ Hayes, Kristen Little, Ray, even Ray, even though he hasn't been here, but also Richard Carr, our GM, and our other GM, my man Van. Oh, and before we go, I got to give a shout out to my man Lester. Lester from, he played in Any Given Sunday. He's actually going to be doing a show here real soon. He was in Any Given Sunday, the big dude, and he was in My Wife and Kids. Had a deep talk with that brother, man, and we're going to have this conversation, so hopefully he'll come in my show one of these days. He was here Sunday. So shout out to my man Lester, man. He's actually a comic, and I told him I'm going to come to one of his shows, and critique his show, you know, then I'm gonna talk about it on the show. So again, I want to thank everybody, but we're gonna go out with my sister Subrock. It's called Queen's Philosophy. Even in here, she speaks about the Moors. Peace and love to everybody. The God Hop Movement. Peace.
Peace. Peace.
My
My philosophy of kings, colossal in its proportions, monopolizing the ring. Putting cats in their places, some royal call me a king. My crown dripping with amethyst gems and thistle leaves. Rocked up and
she gonna say, you don't really want to test the more, listen.
Hips laying thick with waist beads, womb ripe enough to place seeds. I'm smoking for, so fellas, take heed. It sounds so bionic, it can make your face bleed. Take it easy, please. I'm a lover, not a fighter. But keep pressing, sure that you would turn me to a liar. A small drink of water with a belly full of fire. And if there's any question, you could answer to Messiah. My groom studies Sun Tzu war. It's art, my art is war. I could give it all, but trust me, less is more. Say, you don't wanna fucking try to test the more. Slay a devil with the same hand, I bless the poor.
Let me break it down for you again. Baby girl got all the right weaponry. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine.
People sing to like curb style.
Neck and wrist laced up, very little makeup.
Reppin' red, black, and green. Get quiet, listen close, and maybe you'll learn some.
I ain't had to learn the MC, damn it, I was born.
The witch doctor, I healed the sick quick with rich lines, aligning spines to sit proper. Keep my wine charged up and wrapped with thick copper. Pay attention cause I'm prone to shift often. You might find me in the car speaking well up at the bar. Nanga deaf, can I get a bowl of gel up in the star? Psych, I don't drink, I'm cool with OJ in the straw. They hear me rhyme and start to shout alhamdulillah. I control the mic device like a professional. Speak the truth like I'm loose in the confessional. I don't do the rosary thing, I count milas. Rumba St. Gomez, catch a bill with street scholars. My crew deanin', black shine, aura's beaming. Shoulders stay strong in the rep while y'all leaning. Neck lace with gold rope chains, we A-teaming. I spit that good, good, so the crowd stay fiendin',
Let me break it down for you again. Baby girl got all the right weaponry. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine.
People sing the light curve style.
Neck and wrist laced up, very little makeup.
Reppin' red, black, and green. Get quiet, listen close, and maybe you'll learn something.
I ain't had to learn the MC, damn it, I was
born with it.
I rocked the earth, this quick and got hot up on the map. With every verse she rapping, curse the non-believers, they don't know how to act. I tried to told them a slave, but still a slave without the shackles on their wrist. The mental range is still restrained. Step out the box that they created just to lock you in. Got you thinking that your mansion's so much more than just a pretty pen. Silly men try and fail to root the gods, but just enough. Force to make me laugh, I crush them in the match of fist to cuss. Open your eyes, blink once for yes if you with me. Or hide inside your straw hats with the other little pickies. He gon' huff, and he puff, and he blow your house down. Cause the wolf got a taste for the indigenous brown. You know the black of the berry is sweeter juice. Don't bother asking round inside the pudding holes of proof. They idolize the black gods from Mars to floss and space cars. Now the trick is for us to see how powerful we really are.
Let me break it down for you again.
I love Sarat, boy. Fire. Peace, y'all. See y'all Friday, 3 p.m. Pacific time, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Sabir Bey Hip Hop Lessons. We out of here, y'all.
Get quiet, listen close, and maybe you learn something.
I ain't had to learn the MC, damn it, I was born.